Boxing King Media in association with Boxer or Spence. What a great night of boxing. What a great night here outdoors in the football stadium. But controversy, was it low? Wasn't it low? What's your opinion?
It weren't low. That is a fact. It weren't low. I watched it on the monitors. Didn't think it was low when it was thrown. I watched it on the monitors. And I know as an ex-fighter, right, the waistband of the belt line on the body protector, on the bollock protector, is up here, yeah? That landed on the borderline. When you watch it going in there, so it's landing in the pit of the stomach, really, because that protector's quite high. Alexander Usyk was rolling around like it landed somewhere else in his bollocks, and it hadn't landed there. So, you know, and I think with Usyk, you look at the one weakness he does have, if he's got any weakness to his game, is the body shots. He's been floored as an amateur. When he was floored as an amateur, it was with body shots. And he clearly didn't like the body shots in there tonight. Look, I think they made a good point, or we made a good point on there, that VAR may be a way forward, moving forward. When you get clashes of heads and a fighter gets cut and the referee doesn't see it, or whatever, and he just rules it on and then the kid can't continue. You know, we're talking about like a game where, you know, people are putting a lot on the line to get in there, and they're doing it ultimately to feed their families. So VAR might be a good way forward, because that in that instance, their referee could have looked at that and gone, get up, son. Come on, carry on. And then you don't know how that fight's going to turn out, because Daniel was getting some momentum with that. He was growing into that. I think he stopped Rose tonight, by the way, Daniel Dubois. I really do, because he come here and nobody really give him any hope, and I think he's left with a lot of credit. He went in there and he showed a lot of balls in there tonight. Usyk done what he does best. It's proved why he's such a great champion. He turned, forget what happened in the fifth round. The referee ruled it. You got to put that out of your mind and get on with it. You know, Usyk was just biding a bit of time. He clearly hurt to the body, was nicking a bit of time, and it's down to the referee then to make that decision. But what he did do, Usyk, then he got back into that rhythm and he slowly started turning the screw. But great effort from Daniel Dubois, really was. I thought that was a good performance.
I spoke to the referee immediately after the fight and I said, after watching the replay, because he told me watch the replay, I go, did your mind change? Was it low or was it not low? He said it was still low after watching the replay.
Yeah, because he's saying, because that was the low. So what we didn't know, or what we don't know, is when a referee is refereeing a contest, he'll come in, so me and you are fighting, he'll come into my dressing room and say, right, this is, he reads you the rules, basically. This is what I'm allowing, this is what I'm not allowing. The referee may have gone in and said, no waistline. No way to keep it above the waistline. So that's why he would have ruled it a low blow. But the point I'm making here, and you must understand this, so he's ruled it, so that may have been his rule. And so then he's right. But my point I'm making is it wasn't a low blow. But Usyk was acting like it was a low blow. He's rolling around on the floor and all that, like, no, mate, that's not hit you in the bollocks. Get up. You know what I mean? And, you know, he done what he done. And I think it was, yeah, he showed what a great champion he is. You know, put that controversy aside, he put in a performance and yeah, he done well.
We know for Fury, it's Ngannou next before Usyk. Does he now, is the ultimate fight Fury for him? The only fight?
Absolutely. Look, what is he, 36, 37 years of age now, isn't he? So they need to get that fight on sooner rather than later. Fury will be watching that, mate. I don't think he'll be losing sleep over that. I think he'll be quite happy with what he saw. Found some more weaknesses there to Usyk's game. Usyk's great at, like, peppering away, slowly chipping and breaking his opponent down. That's what he does. Slowly but surely breaks his opponents down. You can see him stealing their souls in there, you know, with that peppering jab out of southpaw style. Dubois, though, he showed a lot of bollocks. He hung in there. So, yeah, credit where credit's due. I think Dubois come out a winner as well tonight, because he can take a lot of stock from that.
Spencer, I've got to ask you just away from this. It's surfacing now that the adverse finding from Hellenius seems to be clomiphene. The same adverse finding in Conor Benn, and also the same in Alberto Puello, who was supposed to fight Rolly Romero. The question now, can there be a valid question that is... could there be a bigger problem with clomiphene in food?
Well, it depends where they're all eating, mate, because I don't think they're... We know what clomiphene is, right? We know what it's used for. We know where it sits. And it's a banned substance, an illegal substance. So what is he saying? What is he saying it is? Because I don't know where you would find clomiphene in food. I know what it's used for, but I don't know where you'd find it in food. So, yeah, it's not a good look, mate. I'm going to be honest about it. I don't give a shit, really. It's not a good look. We know what it's used for when you are coming off a cycle, etc., etc. We know what it is. Come on, I'm not fucking going down this whole food thing. I don't know.
Spence, appreciate your time this whole week. It's been a pleasure. See you in about 4 hours on the plane.
I look forward to that, bro.